feel it's now or never, 'cause the future's open wide. Trapped in suspended animation, for too long I've been here waiting. My foot to the brakes every day, and I spend half my life just hungering, and the other half just wondering why nothing was going my way.
Wow, I started.
Alright guys, we are on our way to Nashville, Tennessee to see Beyonce. So it's day 3. Just dropped the girls off and just getting on the road. Making sure the moms know what to do with the girls for dinner and sleep and stuff like that. Like, he's just checking in with them, making sure they have all the rooms.
Give them one day.
So we have about an hour and a half until we get to Nashville. It's really not far from where we live, but I'm really excited. Are you excited?
I'm excited.
So this is like his first like real big concert. What other concerts have you been to?
I've only been to like festivals, Heritage Festival, a whole bunch of artists get together and come. I've never been to a solo act like Beyonce or anything like that. So I'm excited to actually see an icon of this era to perform.
Yeah, I've been to a couple before. I went to, I saw Alicia Keys, and this was a long time ago. John Legend was actually opening for her, so he wasn't nearly as big as he is today back then. But I was a huge fan of Alicia Keys, and she's great still. And I went to a Bow Wow concert when I was like in ninth grade. It was Bow Wow and Mario. I loved Mario. I wasn't really a Bow Wow fan, but I was a huge Mario fan. And so that was cool. And then I went to a Kenny G concert. I won tickets to that on the radio, but I absolutely love like saxophone and jazz music. That's my thing. And I went to the Isley Brothers and Erykah Badu. I love the Isley Brothers and I love Erykah also. So I always wanted to see like a huge icon like Beyonce, so I'm so excited to actually finally be able to see her. But I wanted to see Whitney Houston and didn't make it to see her. I wanted to see Michael Jackson and I didn't get the opportunity to see him either. So I'm so stoked that I can finally see somebody that I've always wanted to see. So that's exciting. Who do you think is going to be opening for her?
I don't know. I think she's going to have a special guest. I don't know who it is. This is our last concert.
Yeah. I'm thinking it's going to be Chloe and Halle because those are her new artists. But you might be right. It might be somebody, like some surprise artist or something. Maybe be Jay-Z or something.
Yeah, that'd be cool. Yeah.
That'd be real cool.
Yeah, get two for one.
Yeah.
So, but we're almost do another milestone together. Haven't had a lot of experiences, but like every experience I've had has been with my wife, so it's been pretty cool. So.
Yeah, before we got married, he didn't really do a lot of traveling, but I did growing up, and so now we get to travel together, and I don't know, I just like to do things. I like making memories and having experiences and stuff, so it's always cool when you get to do it together. And it's especially cool when you get to do it kid-free. I mean, we love our babies, but the time that you get to spend just the two of you is so rare, so we kind of get excited when it's just the two of us.
Yeah, we do. So we're going to have a good day and night, and we'll let y'all know how's going.
All you got to do is say yes. All you got to do is say yes. I want you to let me address you, baby. Open up your mind, just rest.
He thinks he can sing, y'all, but I keep telling him that's not the case. So we are here, and we made it. It's very gloomy looking. So we are hoping that it's just an overcast like the forecast says, and that, you know, since it's outside, that we don't get that word that we're not going to say. So yeah, I mean, I keep thinking I see raindrops, but it's like bugs falling on windshield dying. So anyway, we'll see. Okay, so we are on our way to the Nissan Stadium. We're all dressed and ready to go and pumped to see Beyonce. I'm so excited. So anyway, we're on our way. We are about 15 minutes. Our hotel is about 15 minutes from where she's actually performing. So it's not gonna take us long to get there. But yeah, so we're on our way. We're en route.
Yay.
Oh. He has to be my, you know, Beyonce partner, because it's just like when you get married, you have to support each other. And like, if I'm a fan, he's a fan. So that's just the way we're going to do this tonight. So yes, he's excited too.
So what did you think about the concert?
I thought it was pretty awesome. For my first concert, that was like the probably creme de la creme. She did very well. I knew more songs than I thought.
So how did you like the concert?
I thought it was great. She is so amazing. But no, it was good. I did not like the people that sat in front of us. Because the girl, it was a girl that sat in front of me that was about 10 feet tall. And she swayed, you know, so she would sway like this and I would try to look that way. And then she would sway like this and I try to look that way. And I ended up having to trade seats with you, with Byron, so that I can see, because I'm obviously a bigger Beyonce fan than him. He was like, you can just have my seat. So I was able to see it then, but she did an excellent job. Her production team is amazing. Sparklers, fire, just everything you can imagine. So I was very, very pleased.
If I didn't know more songs than I thought I did, I would have known, because you play the song, Ashley plays the songs all the time, so.
Yeah, he's like, I heard this song before. Oh, I know this one.
Yeah, so it's not probably one song I didn't hear that I never heard before. But all in all, good experience for my first concert.
Okay, sorry for the terrible hotel lighting. But anyway, so we are excited just to, like, be kid-free. Don't get me wrong, I love my babies, and I'm going to be missing them in about tomorrow. But we were, like, excited to be able to go out to dinner and be able to sit our knives wherever we want to sit our knives, and our, you know, our drink glasses wherever we want to sit our drink glasses, without anything being, nobody being stabbed or, you know, drenched. But, okay, the show did start a lot later than we expected. And we got caught in so much traffic that we decided to just buy some food from the restaurant and bring it to our room, because the room was really nice, and that way we can be comfortable and just go right to bed, because we're both exhausted because we had such a long weekend. So we got just something that was still open. It was 11 o'clock, so we went to Waffle House. So we're about to eat some Waffle House, and we got the All-Star Special. I know that's really
All-Star Special.
That's a cheap date, but you know, we just saw Beyonce. There's nothing cheaper about that. So anyway, so we're gonna eat dinner, and then we're gonna go to sleep. It's like almost midnight, so we're gonna eat and go to sleep, which is something that we shouldn't be doing, but that's just what we're gonna do, because it's not an ordinary type night. This is a date night out of town, so that's what we're gonna do. And then tomorrow we'll be on the road again. Hi guys. Hi. We are back from the concert. We're back from Nashville. We've got two of the three girls back. Got Aubrey right here. And got Avery right here. Hey, Ava. And so we are getting ready to tackle this yard. The fall is already getting the best of our yard. So we're going to go ahead and get some raking in. And then we're going to get Abby from the bus stop and take our rental car back. But we hope you guys enjoyed this experience with us and enjoyed watching the video for this week. Check back next week for another video. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. We'll see you guys next week. Bye.
Bye. Your heart is glowing. I'm crashing into you. Baby, kiss me before they turn the lights out. Before they turn the lights out. Baby, love me, lights out. In the darkest night. Time is run out. Yeah.